In the purity of the heart, a poem by Elizabeth Olson. Lord, deliver me from fantasies of self-grandeur that seek to elevate myself as the center of my own existence, that cut off the cords between you and me and see myself as the sole shining star in your created universe. Let me see you with my pure heart, pure mind and tongue. Let me seek to keep you the center of praise and worship. Good morning, dear viewers, and thank you for worshiping with us. I am Cynara Dube-Sookoo, a candidate for ordained ministry, and I am assisting Reverend Ralph Umraw. For this week's moment of inspiration, we are spending some time thinking about God's call to purity. Today, I invite you to silence the world. Let us silence this world that tempts us to place our hopes in our egos. Let us silence the world that tempts us to take justice into our fists and our guns. Then, in this silence, we listen to God's clear and loving call to purity. Bow with me in prayer. Let us pray. God of creation, you are the maker of all things new. This morning, we join in creation's cry of sorrow. We suffer from the plague of our human evils. So we ask, O Lord, in this moment of worship, may the Holy Spirit breathe life anew into us. May our praying, singing, and meditating plant a seed of purity in our hearts that will blossom into a lifetime of discipleship. Hear this, our prayer, through Christ our Lord. Amen. We are blessed to have with us the talented Mrs. Kimberly Khanhai from the Robinson Memorial Presbyterian Church. She leads our hearts in worship with the song, Look Upon the Lord.
Look upon the Lord, stand in awe of His beauty. Look upon the Lord, seated high, He is holy. Let the glory of our God from heaven come down. Let the house of the Lord be filled with a cloud. You are good and your mercy will endure. You are good and forever we are yours. Hallelujah. Listen for the Lord, hear the voice of His Spirit. Call upon His name, He is near, He is with us. Let the glory of our God from heaven come down. Let the house of the Lord be filled with a cloud. You are good and your mercy will endure. You are good and forever we are yours. Hallelujah, hallelujah. with one voice, heaven and earth are singing, holy, holy. With one voice, heaven and earth are singing, holy, holy, holy. With one voice,
Lord, you are good, and your goodness is revealed to us as we meditate on your word. Our scripture reading comes to us from the prophet Malachi, Malachi chapter 3, verses 1 to 3. Let us hear the word of God. The Lord Almighty answers, I will send my messenger to prepare the way for me. Then the Lord you are looking for will suddenly come to his temple. The messenger you long to see will come and proclaim my covenant. But who will be able to endure the day when he comes? Who will be able to survive when he appears? He will be like a strong soap, like a fire that refines metal. He will come to judge like one who refines and purifies silver. As a metal worker refines silver and gold, so the Lord's messenger will purify the priests, so that they will bring to the Lord the right kind of offerings. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God for his word. Amen. As we prepare our hearts to receive this morning's message from Reverend Umraw, I invite you to join in a song that may be familiar to many of us. Our dear Kimberly leads us with Purify My Heart.
Purify my heart. Let me be as gold and precious silver. Purify my heart. Let me be as gold. Holy, save.
Malachi was the last of the Old Testament prophets. The prophet's main concern was to call priests and people to renew their faithfulness to their covenant with God. It was clear that there was laxity and corruption in the life and worship of God's people. Priests and people were cheating God by not giving him the offerings that were rightly due to him and by not living according to his teachings. But the Lord will come to judge and purify the people, sending ahead of him his messengers to prepare the way and to proclaim his covenant. The call to purify has a tremendous impact on the sixth beatitude. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Is the bright particular star in the constellation. We hardly know which is more beyond us, the condition or the promise. Purity of heart or seeing God? What is purity of heart? Heart in the Bible usually means the whole personality. It involves mind and will, not only the emotions. Two meanings are perhaps dominant: rightness of mind and singleness of motive. In Malachi, we hear of the sin of the priests. The climate of the time showed how the people had become complacent in their worship of God. Malachi singled out the priests for condemnation. They know what God required, yet their sacrifices were unworthy, and their service was insincere. If religious leaders go wrong, how will the people be led? We are all leaders in some capacity. Don't neglect your responsibility. Neglects and insensitivity are acts of disobedience. God wants leaders who are faithful and sincere. Malachi then condemns the sin of the people. Men were callously divorcing their faithful wives to marry younger pagan women. This was against God's law because it disobeyed his commands about marriage and threatened the religious training of the children. But pride had hardened the hearts of the people. The people's relationship with God was broken because of their sin, and they would soon be punished. But the few who repented would receive God's blessings, highlighted in his promise to send a Messiah. My dear friends, God deserves our very best honor, respect, and faithfulness. But sin hardens our hearts. Pride is setting your own judgment above God's and looking down on others. Don't let pride keep you from giving God your devotion, money, marriage, and family. God is angry and there is no repentance. He's coming soon to correct iniquities. The purpose of the messenger is to purify the temple and its ministers in preparation for the full advent of God, the judge, For God is conceived of as a king, and the temple is his palace. He cannot come until his house is set in order. His messenger will straighten out the abuses of neglecting God. Hypocrisy and careless living that have devastating consequences. Breaking the laws of God, that is, the Ten Commandments. Call of irrationality and sins of people who are not willing to repent. The Lord proclaimed, "See, I send my messenger who prepare the way before me." Then suddenly the Lord you are seeking will continue his temple. The messenger of the covenant whom you desire will come, says the Lord Almighty. There are two messengers in this verse. The first is usually understood to be John the Baptist. The second messenger is Jesus, the Messiah, for whom both Malachi and John the Baptist prepared the way. In verses 2 and 3, in the process of refining metals, the raw material, or the raw material is heated with fire until it melts. The impurities separate from it and rise to the surface. Without this heat, heating and melting, there could be not purifying. As we are purified by God, his reflection in our lives will be clearer to those around us. God says that leaders, here the Levites, should be especially open to his purification process in their lives. God's patience seems endless in the call to purity. The first messenger is usually understood to be John the Baptist. This is he of whom it is written, "Behold, I send my messenger before thy face, who shall prepare thy way before thee. Truly, I say to you, among those born of women, there has risen no one greater than John the Baptist." John preached God's commandments without fear of others, never yielding to popular opinion. His reputation as a preacher who refused to compromise his conviction. Herod's sin was passed by in silence by all the Jewish authorities, but never for a moment by John. He rose against it as a rock, showing absolute fidelity to the Lord and his word. He stood with God against sin, even though it cost him his life. Let every preacher of God's word take note, for Christ will evaluate each one's ministry, character, and stand against sin. The messenger of the covenant is Jesus, the Messiah. The first and second comings of Christ are united in this passage. But who may abide the day of his coming? It will be the ultimate fulfillment at the second coming of Christ, when he will purify the sons of Levi and judge Israel. He will purge out all the wicked in the land. Only the righteous will remain. He will pour out a blessing if the people would repent, return to God, and as a sign of their repentance, begin to support God's work and ministers with their offerings. God would abundantly bless them. God expects his people to demonstrate their love for and devotion to him and his work by giving offerings to further his kingdom. The blessings that accompany faithfulness in financial giving will come both in this life and in the hereafter. The same quality and blessings are required in our Presbyterian church today and forever. We must, as Christians, fear the Lord. There were still a few in Israel, as well as in Trinidad, who honor God. The Lord promises to keep in heaven a permanent record of those who honor and fear Him by living faithfully before Him. They will not be forgotten. God observes and records our faithfulness to and love for Him. When we stand before Him in heaven, He will remember our devoted commitment and will treat us accordingly. My dear sisters and brothers in Christ, let us not only be called to purity, but let us be pure in heart, true and sincere in all our activities. We shall leap with joy when we see the Lord on Judgment Day in the kingdom of heaven. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Almighty and eternal God, we are living in a world filled with corruption, greed for power, and greed for possession. Lord, help us to purify ourselves. And through your love and compassion, there can be a change in our hearts, in our minds, and in our spirit, O Lord. We thank you for this golden opportunity whereby we can preach the gospel to our people. Lord, let us be receptive to your kindness, to your humility. Everywhere in this beautiful land, there is corruption, dishonesty, unfaithfulness. But we can change our attitude and behavioral pattern. Lord, forgive us for the wrong things that we have done in the past. And let there be a pure spirit in our life. Blessed are the poor, pure in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. All these blessings, O Lord, I ask in your precious name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray. Amen.
Thank you so much, Reverend Umraw, for reminding us of God's call to immerse our hearts, our thoughts, and our deeds in purity. May God continue to bless you and your family as you continue your journey in ministry. Friends, our PCTT has many activities that we can be a part of. On Saturday, 16th February, our Presbyterian Church women invite you and your family to their annual conference at the Naparima College Auditorium in San Fernando at 9 a.m. The theme is Come, Everything is Ready. On behalf of the Board of Youth Affairs, we would like to invite all our youth to a one-day leadership training workshop. This will be held on Saturday, 2nd March from 8:30 a.m. at the Runodai Presbyterian Church in Coover. The name of the event is Developing the Leader in You. Our youth are indeed the leaders of tomorrow and even our leaders of today. So we encourage you to identify the young people of your congregations who have that special leadership potential so that they may attend and grow that potential into a reality. If you need any further details, please contact our church's office via our website at www.pctt.org.tt. At this time, we reflect on God's transformative work in our lives as Kimberly shares with us the song, The Potter's Hands.
Beautiful Lord, wonderful Savior, I know for sure all of my days are held in your hands. Grafted into your perfect hand. You gently call me into your presence, guide me by your Holy Spirit. Teach me, dear Lord, to live all of my life through your eyes. I'm captured by your holy calling. Set me apart. I know you're drawing me to yourself. Lead me, Lord, I pray. Take me, mold me, use me, fill me. I give my life to the potter's hand. Hold me, guide me, lead me, walk beside me. I give my life to the potter's hand.
Thank you, Kimberly, for sharing with us this morning with your wonderful ministry in music. May God continue to hold you and bless you as you continue in this wonderful ministry. Friends, this brings us to an end of our program today, but we encourage you to subscribe, like, and share this episode from our YouTube channel, Presbyterian Church, Trinidad and Tobago, or from our Facebook page at Moments of Inspiration. You are also welcome to join us for worship, to fellowship with us in person at any one of our 107 congregations of the Presbyterian Church. I leave you now with today's moment of inspiration. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.